There are, of course, dozens of popular conspiracy theories regarding scientists and science.
I shall perfect my own race of people. A race of atomic supermen that will conquer the world.
Did you know one of the most popular of these theories has to do with geologists and geophysicists who are insidiously trying to prevent the public from finding out that the Earth is expanding?
There is a kind of conspiracy of silence among certain scientists. 100 years of scientific theory out the window. The simple truth is apparently too upsetting to too many apple carts.
And as we all know, scientists hate new ideas. The idea of an expanding Earth was originally proposed in the late 19th century. It never really achieved much traction among physicists and geologists, partly because no one ever really proposed a plausible mechanism by which the expansion took place. The idea occasionally reappeared in the 20th century, for example, in the work of Otto Christoph Hilgenberg in Germany in the 1930s, and in the 1940s in the work of the Australian geologist Samuel Warren Carey. More recently, the idea has been rescued from obscurity and popularized among the Comic-Con crowd by illustrator Neil Adams. Apparently, Adams found one of Warren Carey's forgotten books in a used bookstore or something, and, for whatever reason, became fired with enthusiasm for the idea of an expanding Earth. Springing forth from the fertile soil of Neil Adams' expanding Earth evangelism has been an entire pseudoscience industry dedicated to the idea of a growing Earth. There are dozens of books, and they all have one thing in common: a conspiracy theory regarding the world's geologists and geophysicists. In this video, I can't do full justice to the subject or explain in great detail why the expanding Earth hypothesis was jettisoned, why it doesn't, in fact, explain observed data, and why plate tectonics does. But let's take a brief look at what I thought was one of the funnier sections in Neil Adams' video.
Check this map out. The Navy and others took core samples to find the ages of the sea bottom. Lo and behold, no part of the undersea was found to be much older than 70 million years old. Does that shock you? It should. It shocked the scientists.
And of course, the fact that oceanic crust gets older and older as one travels farther from mid-ocean ridges was one of the confirming bits of evidence for plate tectonics. Incidentally, Neil's video understates the age of oceanic crust. The oldest crust is in the Northwest Pacific Ocean, and it's about 140 million years old. But of course, the age of oceanic crust isn't what gives expanding Earth enthusiasts heartburn.
As we now go forward in time from 185 million years ago, please notice there is no subduction, no raising and lowering of land masses. There can't be. It's hell in the form of magma down there. Local raising and lowering, yes, but not on a massive basis. It can't happen.
Actually, subduction can and does happen. That's why we have earthquakes and a ring of fire around the Pacific Rim. And subduction zones can actually be indicated by mapping seismic waves from earthquakes. Utilizing seismic data from earthquakes, we can map subduction beneath continents at subduction zones. In case you watch Neil's video, you'll be looking for an explanation as to why subduction cannot happen. Essentially, the video states it does not happen because, well, it just can't. In other words, all it does is state personal incredulity. It goes on to state that oceanic crust cannot be subducted into a mantle that is denser than granite. Well, that's kind of the point. Oceanic crust is denser than granite. Continents are granite, so a tectonic plate carrying a continent, when it collides with an oceanic plate, just by basic physics, the oceanic plate slides beneath the continent. Not that there isn't a great deal of friction involved. Hence, earthquakes. Before I move on, I do want to preserve one moment from my old video on this topic. And this is for you biologists.
65 million years ago and more, these continents were joined and marsupials like the duckbill platypus roamed from Australia, Antarctica, and across southern South America and up into Africa.
Duckbill platypuses are not, in fact, marsupials.